I mean, I think it was good that he started his campaign there. But you need to show up and talk to people. You need to listen to what their concerns are. And he, I mean, if I was him, I mean, I would be all around the state. I mean, that's what I did when I ran. Here's what I learned as governor. If I mean, I shook hands with probably 600,000 people in a little over 8 years, right? When I ran and when I, they care about it. The way I look at it is jobs, but the truth is they want to have independence. We all want to, I mean, you want to be independent, right? We all want to be independent. You know, you don't want to be dependent on somebody else. That's number one. Number two is the future is their kids. They want their kids to get a good education. And number three is they want to be safe. So we're, one of the reasons why the president's doing well in Florida right now is because he's focused on safety. He's focused on people understand you don't have a border, you have less safety. All right. There's wonderful people that want to come to our country, and they should, because this is the greatest economy in the world. But there's also terrorists that want to come to our country. There's people who want to sell drugs into our country. Do we want to stop those to help take care of all our families? Yeah. So I'd say it's, I think it's three things. I think it's one, jobs, two, education, three, it's public safety. But on top of that, why don't we fix healthcare? Why don't we do something that would actually drive the cost of healthcare down? If you want people to get more healthcare, it's not an issue. The issue is why does it cost so much? That's why I've proposed bills that would that say we're not going to pay more for prescription drugs than the Europeans pay. Why do we pay more? You're going to know what things cost. You're never going to get a surprise bill if you go to a hospital. And you ought to know, I want a database for all pharmaceutical drug costs. So you can shop. You can say, oh, I can go to this place and it's cheaper than this place.
President Trump's campaign recently rolled out their pitch to Latinos, specifically targeting Florida. It seems like that's where they did the big launch in Miami.
The most important state, of course.
Latinos for Trump. Do you think that the support for Trump is there in Florida among Latinos?
I Latinos think the same way we do. What do they care about? They want to be self-sufficient. They want a job, right? What, we have the lowest unemployment in the history of the country over 50 years or something. That's important to everybody, whether you're Latino or not. They want their kids to get a great education because that's the dream. They want to be safe just like us. We did a right after my election in November, we did a poll on immigration. And basically, I think it was like 69% of Hispanics in Florida said they wanted stronger enforcement of immigration laws, which is about the same as everybody else as a percentage. So it's, you know, people, we all want the same thing.
And as you know, Florida swing state, and it's critical for 2020.
The most important state.
Yes. So how do Republicans and how do President Trump win Florida?
I mean, I think it was good that he started his campaign there, but you need to show up and talk to people. You need to listen to what their concerns are. If I was him, I mean, I would be all around the state. I mean, that's what I did when I ran. I talked to as many people as I could talk to and listen to what their issues are and make sure you're addressing what their concerns are. So make sure you're getting things done that is important to them, or you have a proposal to get something done that's important to them.